I'm Sir Tap Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Electronic Highways. You can play in English or... is that Russian? I don't know. Got some credits. Let's just look at the credits here. Parker? Ugh. So yeah, short little credits. Oh, there's mine. See, this is a surreal... doomy-looking weird thing. It's supposed to only be like 40 minutes long, according to How Long to Beat. So it's some sort of like VR thingy, like not real VR, but like, ugh. There's so many games that are confusing now that VR is like a practical thing, sort of practical thing. It's kind of funny. There's this timer, there's this upload timer, and then the game will immediately tell us that the timer isn't a real thing and don't worry about it. I'm not sure. I've only played this first thing. Oh, got some V-Sync issues. Or rather, lack of V-Sync. I thought I forced V-Sync, but whatever. I don't think you will see this screen tearing anyway, so that's what's important. So it looks very doomy, except we've got mouse look. Fast movement. Let's move my... put down my mouse speed a little bit. I've got this, I think it's Logitech G500. You can change your DPI on the fly. I don't use it too often. I don't usually use it for the, you know, elite scopes, which is what it's intended for, but, it is useful when some games are, like, way too sensitive or way not sensitive enough. So I can pick between one of five DPI settings on the fly. I think I usually keep it around... oh man, I forget exactly what it is, actually. I think it's around 2000. You can go way down or way high. Like, let's put it to the max here. This is the max. I am just slightly moving it. This is me moving it normally. It's just pretty ridiculous. And this is the lowest setting. Actually, still pretty fast in this game. But it's pretty slow on the desktop. I use it actually to pick screen areas for Flash games, because it's usually pretty painful. So one thing I noticed is that the music's pretty cool, and it's really... it just seems like a really cool game to relax in. I should mention, this game is actually free. It is on Steam. You can... I think it's also on itch.io. But if you prefer Steam, you can just go find it on Steam. So we just did a thing. Let's go find the consequences of that thing that we did. Oh! They're like icicles! Oh, that's cool. I really love surreal depictions of, like, understandable objects like that. Like, the icicles. Like, these don't look like anything. These are just, like, platforms. But then you see the drippy, and you know it's an icicle. I just love something like that. Like, oh! Well, that's one way to show it's new. There's another way to show it's new. What are you? You look threatening somehow, but can we go now? Did those marks used to be there? Yes, they did. Okay. Oh. This door wasn't open before. Okay. See, the drippy! Ooh. I love the aesthetic so far. Oh! We're out here now? This is the area we were at before, isn't it? What is this? Oh, they killed him! Rest in peace, Yellow Peg. You will be missed. Portal! Okay. I'm gonna guess that big door is open now. Yep. Ah, cool. I love the thing, I love when you can sort of peek into where you're gonna be later. This is my receiver in hopes of... oh, that's why it's 30 minutes, maybe. Because I guess it's possible to, buildings!
What are you doing?
Sorry, my cat's being annoying, as always. There was a thing there. Oh, it's like steam. Oh, buildings! Indeed. Okay. I love when games, like, totally shift aesthetics each level. Like, it's so cool. That's not sarcasm. Hello? What? I guess you're a camera? Okay. it's fine. There's no, like, gun button. There's, like, a, oh! Excuse you? Ugh, the frickin' ow. The, screen tearing is really bad with that object. Did that activate something else? Nothing in there. Oh, here we go. What is this? Nothing fancy. You know what? I kind of miss the ridiculous Doom walls. What was that sound? Another one. Up, oh, up. Oh. Crushed by the wheels of industry once again? Yes, I have been. Wait, is this just a 2D? Yeah, it's just 2D. Huh. Okay. What is? I'm liking this. It's so weird. I love anything weird and artsy. Just send me. Ideally short, weird, and artsy. Those are the three most important things that I enjoy the most. Because, I mean, I don't even care if a game is short as long as it's, like, reasonably priced. I worry more about games wasting my time than games not being worth the money. I saw you, blue ghosty man. I'm gonna find you. Freaking cheese grater things. Hello? Am I following you now? Okay. Hurry up, bro. Oh, you're gonna open this, aren't you? Calling it. I am calling it. I love climbing stupid slopes. Whee! I knew it! I knew it! Yes! Just run through the broken glass. It's always a good thing. You should always run through broken glass, children. It will help your skin be healthy. We got a key card! Oh! Portal to the hashtag. We gotta go find the hashtag door. Hashtag door YOLO. I use Twitter like constantly. I still find it impossible to take the term hashtag seriously, honestly. Oh. That's so weird. The like wind or whatever doesn't push us, but it makes that weird sound when it goes past us. I think this area is new? No, it's definitely not new. Alright, did we go this way then? What is this? Is this the exit? This seems exit-y. It's so dramatic. Ah! Yep. Oh man, it's one of those Doom portals! I love that. It's just like a window to the skybox. And that's just how portals work, because it's freaking like, oh man, when did Doom release? You know, 90, I don't remember. I was a tiny baby at the time. This new world is a giant sea. Other neon, woo! Oh, pretty. It's just a gradient, but it's cool. I'm digging the music too. Is there a word for this sort of, like, weird lo-fi glitchy stuff? Like, I always call it glitch chic myself, but, I don't know if there's, like, a formally accepted term. Probably, like, glitch punk or something stupid with punk at the end of it. You know, the aesthetics changing every level kind of reminds me of, Flower. Oh, this game is old, I think. Like, not super mega old, but I think I'm a few years late to playing it, but that's fine. I play oldish games all the time. Is there? Am I? What do? I'm missing something here. Oh! Is this one activated? It looks like it. Do you make weird sounds too? No. It's actually wind this time. You know, if wind was actually strong enough to push you up like it is in video games, it would, like, probably pretty much crush you the moment you, like, touched an object. Like, it would probably be pretty bad. I love these just lines. The benches are just lines in these things. And the water is just a texture. I honestly enjoy a lot of those old weird shortcuts that look, you know, that kind of worked. What is this? It spins! It spins! And the simple delight of, like, finding crap that, like, changes your vision or moves you around just a little bit, like, anything like that was exciting back then. Got a weird little thing. Aw, we can't jump into it from here. We got some symbols going on. Were those lit up before? I don't think they are. Maybe we're bringing the city to life. That reminds me even more of Flower then. Oh man, if you haven't played Flower and you have a PlayStation 3, 4, or Vita, you gotta play Flower. It's just... What is this? Is this just art? Are we supposed to appreciate the art? Okay, I think we've sufficiently appreciated the art. Is there? Oh! I'm stupid. There we go. Ah, this is just somebody's porn archive just put into ones and zeros. I'm surprised, like, I know people find binary more recognizable, but I figured, like, somebody would represent hexadecimal in stuff like this. You know, to show data, but it's so rare to see hexadecimal in anything like that. You're just there. I'm also a big sucker for being able to see stuff from multiple perspectives like that. Alright. We got this nice bench at the end of the world here. What's that? There's something in that building. Oh, we got the symbol. Boop. Oop. What'd you do? There's fountains. Oh, the world is coming apart. Sorry. It's fine. Splat. Oh, it's water! That's so cool. Alrighty. I guess we go in here. What's in the door? It's the art. Oh wait, not. No, it's not. Sometimes I think I'm on an endless virtual highway. Same. Same. Across the plaza. Oh, oh, you're gonna... Oh, that's cool. What is that? The floor. It's the floor. It's just loopy. Oh, man. I love this kind of crap. Parker, what are you doing? I don't know what's up with Parker today. Aeronaut. Bloop, bloop. I really dig the Doom-like aesthetic that some... I've seen a few modern indie games go for it. Borders Destroyer. Wait, is that a gun? Are we actually gonna get a gun? It's officially a game now! Aw, cool. It's weird gooey stuff in our way. Borders Destroyer. Take that, table! Take that, other table! You're all going down! No table goes undestroyed. This is why you can't give me power. I'll destroy all of your tables. And your vases. Screw your tables. Your other frickin' tables. And your vases and your glass windows. It just makes me sick. This is great. This is the best ever. Alright, there's too many tables. We just need there to be less tables, okay? That's what's going on. Alright, I'm not sure which way to go first. Let's go this way. The, like, purple stuff, or not purple, the opposite of purple. Green stuff is, like, clogging up all the areas that we were in before. Borders Destroyer. I love ridiculous descriptions of, like, mundane objects like that. So, we've got to destroy everything. It's just how it's got to be. These tables are preventing me from having inner peace. Once I destroyed all of them. Oh man, these ones look ominous. Oh my gosh, this reminds me of, it's like the thing in Ocarina of Time. There's, in Death Mountain Crater or something. There's like a bunch of jars or something that block your way. And you need, it's to block your path if you don't have bombs. So I'll just show. That it is. Oh! I see. Well then. That's. Huh. I like that. I like that a lot. Let's take a dip. Oh man! It's just like the Doom Water! Aren't you sick of their lack of risk? I am. I really am. Ah! We got a little brain thingy. Aeronaut. It's probably some sort of anagram. I'm not good at decoding anagrams on the fly, though, so. Sorry. If there's some obvious meaning to that, I'm sure I'm missing it. Smashy, smashy! If you haven't watched The Simpsons, you're not gonna get some of my jokes. I mean, if you haven't watched The Simpsons, you don't deserve to get some of my jokes. I mean, what's wrong with you? At least the early Simpsons, like the first... I forget what the exact agreed-upon cutoff date is, but it's like around the first 10 to maybe 13 seasons? I'm not sure what they're up to anymore. I haven't watched them in years, but, oh. Take that door. Whoop. Cars and trucks fly by you when you're standing on a virtual highway. Okay. Oh! Space Lab Telecon! Okay. Can I just... No. Oh, man. And skyboxes. Just... Skyboxes were just amazing. Like, in, I think Unreal Tournament 99 was the first time I saw a real, like... I got impressed with the skybox. The Phobos Moonbase thingy. A little camera thingy. Or was it Phobos? I think I'm thinking of Doom. But like, there's a moon thingy with like low gravity and stuff. Welcome to Telecon, a place that was built in one day. Seems like a reasonable thing to build in one day. Got a server or something here. I like those doors. I like everything. Oof. This is so cool. Oop, what do we got here? You see, we never met and we don't have names. I see. Can I break things? Oop! They're already broken. Okay. I'm getting out of fucking another one of those symbols to open that up. We're being observed for some reason, which is weird because it's like. Isn't this supposed to be our VR dream? You'll love it when the machines observe you. Why, thank you. I could go for some observation. What you got for me? Ah. Ow. It's like the world's most painful QR code. Laser bridge! Laser bridge! I love laser bridges, because they make no sense. You can't walk on light. Whatever. We nearly replicated a human once after the observing. Oh. I see. Can I go in? Oh, I want to go in. Ah. There's no crouch button. I just want to fall in that endless pit. Ugh. I miss my borders smasher or whatever. Border breaker. Beepy, beepy, beepy. Beepy, beepy. Why is it beepy? Why, starfish? Why is it beepy? Sorry, I need to stop doing that with the mouse. Beepy!
Beepy!
Sampling and holding, we need another unit. So you are observing me. How flattering. Please observe, come observe with us. Turn with us. Okay, I think I will. Thank you. I'm loving it. Horrific observation. I'm loving it. The system is gonna explode now, so let's just continue on. We're also run down, we only fade away. Computers are worried about dying. That sucks. Oh! Pretty. It's just blotches. Something I rarely see explored is the idea of just partially built virtual worlds, and I just love stuff like that. Something I loved in Dot Hack. What am I doing here? We're so sure, so wrong. But now there's only us. Aw, you killed the humans, didn't you? Oh well. May as well follow you anyway. Love by numbers, Liz and Wires. Take a step, now it's disconnected. 15 minutes. Metroland! Woo! There's a lot of different areas. I'm pretty impressed. They're like changing every, 5 minutes. It's really cool. Spoopy. Teleporting! But of course. Yeah, it's kind of weird. It took until Portal for people to really think of, like, a portal that's just, like, just a hole that you just look right through. Instead of, these weird swirly things. Like, maybe just because it was harder to render graphics like that? I don't know. Starts at the top. Now it's spiraling down. I like that. I really love the weird geometry and the lack of need to connect everything. It gives you a really cool, uniquely virtual space. Something I really wish more games would explore aesthetics like this. I don't really need, like, in VR, this is the sort of stuff I want to see in VR. I don't really need to see more. Oh! What we got going on here? I don't need to see more, virtual pretty places. Like, realistic stuff is okay, but we've already got realistic places. We don't have, like, real places like this. Oh, I love that. I love the wall that's just a portal to the skybox. That was a really cool effect. Like, it's not, like, super complicated. But it just works. Are we just supposed to see that the computers are overheating, or is there something to do here? Are they just supposed to see that they're overheating or something? Alright, let's continue on. Now I'm wondering if this dev made any other stuff. Little light poles and baby light poles. You can climb them. Excellent. Alright, what are we doing here? Am I supposed to activate this or something? Why am I here? Oh! Left or right? Looks like I'm blocked here, so. Oh man, this is reminding me of. I can't remember the hell. It's like Multithedius or something. It's like some weird half-made-up name. I should take a look at that again. Try to make a video of it. What happened? I don't know. Don't blame me. I didn't break it. Boop. What's this? Oh. It's that room we were in before. Now we gotta go all the way around again, right? Wait. Yeah. It was this room that had the door, right? Yes, okay. I'm making pretty good time. I was kind of worried that I would get lost or something. This is not much to see when you're lost. I can specialize in romance, serving shinders at the spines. Along the park. The park! It's just the park! Look at the park. It's lovely. You've got your endless gray expanses and your blue fire. Blue fire is nice. I'm a bit more partial to the endless gray expanses personally, though. Got some lamps, some very simple lamps here. Can I jump on the fire? Yes, I can jump on the fire. Okay. What's this? Gray trees. Gray is just my favorite manner of tree. Got a crystal ball. We don't need a crystal ball. We got computers to tell us how to live our lives. We got gray fire. You know, that's... Gray is my second favorite kind of fire after the blue fire. We've got some sort of summoning circle and or horrible bloodstain or something. Just a nice walk in the park. This is, you know, this is my favorite sort of date here. You know, you take her for a nice romantic date in the endless gray park. You go to observe the horrible undulating circle room. You do that for a few hours. Then you take her through to the, you know, to the unspeakable corridor. And that's pretty nice. But then sometimes you just want some gray trees. That's okay. You know, nobody's going to judge you for that. And sometimes you just want to go into the bird projection room. And you just want to put your eyes right up into the projection system. That's so cool that this room just kills the music. Just birds. You want to see those birds. Oh, we got a thing. You can sort of see it from outside the window. Oh, it's the Gray Fire. Hi, Gray Fire. How do you do? I want to touch you. Aw, we can't touch the Gray Fire. That'll ruin your date right there. If you go to the Gray Fire but you can't touch it, she's not gonna be into that, man. I'm sorry. It just... Oh, here we go. This is how most of my dates end. With shadowy trees and fire everywhere. You know, what can I say? I'm a romantic. 8! We're going to Final Fantasy 8, guys! Parker's excited for Final Fantasy 8. Parker, I can't see. I could be seeing actual Final Fantasy 8, but I wouldn't know because Parker's butt is blocking the entire screen. Parker, please. I can see some balls. Parker, get down. Okay. The ball fountain? It's a very romantic location, the ball fountain. Do not fall into the ball fountain. Do not taunt Happy Fun Ball Fountain. Ball! Parker! Parker. Don't you tell me off. Parker, I'm platforming! First person platforming is always just great. Oh! We got a thing. Fire! Okay, now we can open that symbol. Where did we see that symbol? We saw that a while back. It was not in this room. It was... I think this is the way back. Sorry, Parker's now sitting on the keyboard, so if anything goes horrifically wrong, blame Parker. I love that droppy down effect. Can we just go into the fire? Yes, we go into the fire. I made a contract with another world. I'm afraid it's not me talking. Same. Oh, we're in brick hell now. Just spooky dungeon. Spooky dungeon. Got some spooky dungeon wisps. Some spooky dungeon cobwebs. Spooky dungeon sounds. Spooky dungeon blocked corridors. Okay. Okie dokie. Remember what I told you about neon lights? I told you, bro! Told you about neon lights, bro! Aw, man, we missed a secret! That's secret number 4. We missed secret number 3. Now I feel bad. Where was secret number 3? If anybody knows what secret number 3, could you please leave a comment? I don't want to miss anything. I love that everything changes. It's like so... It's really cool what this game does. And remember, this is free, so you can just go punk around yourself instead of watching me derp around. I want VR stuff like this, like, immediately. I want to be in weird, screwed up worlds. Oh! Was this here before? I thought that was a wall. Whatever. Hello. The sizzling. Box! Oh, we can't push the box. Boop. Well, this place is a bit different from the others, even more so than usual. Something going wrong with our program? It's very, you know, it's funny, this place is very complete compared to the other programs, like, in terms of, you know, realism and, like, everything sort of makes sense. But it's still, like, the gloomiest and worst. Oh no, this is where I came from, isn't it? Or is it? Oh man, I'm so lost. Oh, we got a new area. We got another symbol. We got a bullseye. We got to go to Target, guys. They get a... Oop, Parker's touching the keyboard. Oh, we already found... We're going to Target! We're gonna buy some reasonably priced goods. Oop! It's dead. It's all bloody. Or purpley. It melted. But this isn't where it came from. Hello, Zombie Jesus. Bye, Zombie Jesus. Into the darkness. Only when I see the light, I feel like more than just a number. Up. Crawling time. Oh, the sketchiness. I love the sketchy look. It's so cool. We're like peeking down into little cubicles or something. What is this? Some interesting music going on. Whoop. And we're in sketchy land. The egg! All praise the egg. Worship the egg. That's enough worshiping the egg. I love those like little bits missing from the walls. Oh, what's this? I got words. Welcome to the time-wasting chamber. Step into the chamber to begin the time-wasting process. Remember to push a button every minute or else the timer reset. Okay. Time-wasting chamber. Oh. This is the most dramatic time-wasting chamber I've ever been in. Do we actually have to do this? I'm gonna press it once, and then I'm gonna leave. Wait, am I trapped? Oh, we reset it. Alright. I'm pretty sure that's just... Aw, the light switch doesn't work. I'm pretty sure that's just to fuck with you. So I'm just gonna leave it alone. Oh, nice window. Nice door. Oh well. I wanna see everybody's high score in the time-wasting chamber. And you better be honest. I'm gonna know if you lied. Oop, what was that? It's a little brighter on some of these squares. What the? Oh, it's the being close to the lights. Okay. Parker, could you please sit down? And into the ravine. I feel like we must have missed something. Because that feels like a one-way trip. Oh, no it's not, because this is the time-wasting chamber again. Alright, let's go this way then. I want to explore everything, but I don't want to get too lost. Oh, I thought that was glass. Oh, you need another symbol. Hand-drawn picture. Yes, yes it is. Eh? Eh? I've already been here. Okay, what did I miss? Please tell me I don't actually have to do the time-wasting chamber. This door. Arg. Alright, let's waste 1 minute. So, how you people been? You enjoying the winter weather out there? You know, there was a fly in my house the other day. Yesterday, actually. I'm not sure if that counts as the other day. I don't think so. I was like, how are you alive, Mr. Fly? That does not make sense. Must have come in with my groceries. What do you have to say, Mr. Parker? Do you have any opinions on this time-wasting chamber? Every chamber is a time-wasting chamber for you, isn't it? Alright, hang on. Parker, we need to keep close observation of the time. It's better to do something. So, please leave your reviews for the time-wasting chamber in the appropriate review slot. Please make sure to only leave objective reviews. This is an objective game review only zone, so if you leave a subjective review, you are actually a communist. I hope that did something. I don't think it did, though. Oh, yeah. But speaking of objective reviews, my My website is officially a real game journalist now because somebody complained that my review was not objective enough. So, you know, that's how you know you're real. I mean, that somebody complains that you're not objective in your review, because, I mean, there's just an objective fact about how good a game is, and you need to say that, you know? Wait, this is the door, isn't it? Aw, fuck. Okay, maybe it's something in that room. This game's screwing with me. I was worried I would get lost. Also, I'm pretty sure we're past the 30-minute point at this point.
Okay, so that's the door.
That's it. What's this? Red door? Can't do the red door. What do I do? Oh! Is the red door open now? It sure is. Ah! How did I not notice that? Whatever. Where's the red thingy? It was in here, right? Arg. It's a thing! Alright, next room. Everything stops if I close my eyes. Memories will hold me tight. We're getting close to the end of the dream. Possibly. Eh? I can't control my thing. Is this a cutscene? I guess it's a cutscene. Is this the virtual highway? A new dawn comes, cold from the heat of night. Okay. Parker's getting up. He's bored. Parker. Honey, I can't see. Sit down. If you're gonna sit, if you're gonna be on the table, you gotta sit. Get down, please. Parker? You're so fussy. Get down. Just lay down or get off the table. Come on. This is very troublesome. Please, get down.
Yeah, I didn't see what this area is called. Borders Destroyer. Oh,
why did my mouse flip around? I need the Borders Destroyer. Got some textures. What the f- What? Stop that. David San! Is it like Onion San? Got some lovely purple water here. Parker, leave me alone. I think we must need that Borders Destroyer. David San. Ah! Fucking... Okay, so it's trying to leave the area that does that, I guess. What's in here? That's glass. Oh no, we missed a thing, so I don't know if we can activate Parker! Activate that. Didn't you die earlier? No, that was a yellow one. You're a green one. Ah. Warm leatherette. Warm leatherette, indeed. Yoink! Is that a jet? That sure is. Not sure what that was about. Borders Destroyer! I need that Borders Destroyer. It's real. It's really real. I think I can make that jump, but I want to see where this goes first. Oh, I think that unlocks the path to the Borders Destroyer.
David San!
Oh, Davey O-San. Let's destroy some borders, shall we? That does not qualify as a border, I guess. Let's find some borders. Does anybody have some borders that they need destroyed? Get out of here, border! Aw. That's not a border. It just looks like a border. We got some doom elevators. Come on. Take that, border. Get destroyed. It's the little... It's freaking WD Gaster. We saw him earlier. Well, we got the symbol, but where the hell did we go? Oh, I guess there, maybe? Can we cross the street or does that kill us or something? suddenly no music. Do we really need the... neat. Do we really need the Border Destroyer for a single pane of border? Got some black spots in the ceiling here. Okay. Do you need any borders destroyed in this portal here? Egg, do you need your borders destroyed? That's a noisy room. Destroy the border! Destroy it! Ah! Ow. Oh, you were supposed to destroy the borders. Take that, egg. Your yolky goodness is no more. And thus we destroyed the border. And the hallways are far behind, but I am still here. Oh! Did I wake up? Did I break my own simulation? Did I die? Still in this goddamn chamber with shiny neon monitors around. Looking into this world, but I was glad to escape it. Neon numbers and ways to escape. New ways. New ways. Dun dun dun. Boop. Oh, so the timer is meant to roughly coincide with how long it takes to play the game. So that's clever. So it sort of ties you in to the 30 minutes, even though due to cutscenes, it actually takes a little more than 30 minutes. So the developer is Zikoi Eddie. Eddie site, eddieprojects.blogspot.ru. So yeah, I'll definitely see if he has any other stuff to play. Special thanks to NerdyBat, Ivan Azarov, Artwork, BKC, lots of people. Thanks for playing. You're welcome. Ending simulation.